president, so that's the name of you. Now, these guys are a communal spawning fish, and what that means is that the male fish makes a nest, and females lay their eggs in that nest, and then you get mixing all the different types. You'll get green sunfish mixing with a red-breasted sunfish, and so their babies have both the characteristics. It makes them really cool. Now, they also eat lots of different stuff out in the wild. They eat primarily on small bugs and shrimp, but they also eat smaller fish and even plant material from time to time. So it helps them survive everywhere. But here at the hatchery, we feed them primarily to a pink shrimp called krill. Now, krill comes from the ocean, and we get it in big frozen blocks. And the reason we use saltwater shrimp to feed our freshwater fish is because if there are any parasites or diseases, they wouldn't be able to survive in fresh water for very long. So it provides our fish something safe and healthy to eat, which is very important. So as the krill gets to the bottom, though, it gets cleaned up by a few other species. One is that large gray fish over there, with that big old mouth on it. You know, it's got a very flat tummy and that bottom-facing mouth. He is a freshwater krill. But he's also got another funny name. It's called a Gasper Goose. So with that flat tummy, you can get all the way to the bottom and clean up the aquarium very nicely for me. But like they do up in the wild, they keep our lakes and rivers clean and any dead or dying food items you might collect at the bottom. So they're a very beneficial fish to eat. Another fish that really likes the krill kind of stands up from his peers, this guy right here. He's blue and he's got all these little bright specks on him and a couple of black dots. That is a Texas cichlid. I've got a whole mess of them, a bunch of little guys cruising along the bottom of the aquarium. And those guys are only found out of the Rio Grande River Valley in the southernmost part of Texas. That's because they're a warm water species. They don't like water temperature below about 60 degrees. Over the winter time, most of the water temperature outside is well below that, because they won't survive in this part of Texas. So we have to keep them indoors in our aquarium, where we can keep the water temperature above about 78 degrees for it. So they like that a lot more.